In today's video, I am going to take you with me on a journey on how to travel from Africa to Europe during COVID-19. What's up, everybody? My name is Saloua. I am a digital entrepreneur coach and a digital nomad currently in Morocco. I've lived in Morocco for the last 6 months, and tomorrow is my last day as I'm traveling to Europe, Belgium to be precise. And I'm going to take you with me on that journey and show you step by step what you need to know, what documents do you need, what website you should check out. And then I will show you what I'm doing during the day before I get to Europe. So let's go. Okay, the first thing you need to do is, before you book your ticket, you need to check the regulations based on the country you are traveling to. So I'm gonna put down below a couple of websites that I use. One is flattenthecurve.global. This is a website I check to get the information. I also go into the embassy website and check the regulation before traveling. And then I check a couple of other websites regarding the news, world news about travels, COVID, etc. Once I do that and I'm confident that I can travel, I go ahead and book my ticket. When you look at flight online on Google, just know that you need to double check and go onto the airline website to make sure your flight hasn't been canceled, because sometimes it takes a while for Google to update the information from the airline website. Then when you book, make sure you book with an airline that offers free change or reimbursement in case the flight is canceled. Make sure to read the airline regulations to make sure you are up to date. For example, one little detail that I had forgotten is that some airlines require a specific face mask. So in this case, I have to get an FFP2 mask or a surgical mask. So that's something that I didn't know and I had to check before I head to the airport. So let me show you exactly where I'm looking for after I have booked my flight. First thing first, you need to go and get your PCR test 72 to 48 hours before your flight. Again, check the regulation with the airline and the country you are going to, because sometimes even if you are vaccinated, they might require you to get tested as well. You need to also check out if you need to quarantine, yes or no, and if you have to get tested again upon landing and 7 days after that. So make sure you check that, because it changes from countries to countries. All right, first thing, I'm gonna go get my PCR test. I've already made an appointment and we're going right now. So let's go. Today is Monday morning. I'm gonna go get tested. I should get my result by tonight. And then tomorrow afternoon is my flight. So let's do it, come on. So we just came back from the lab where I got tested. So I should get my result by tonight at 6 p.m. I have to go back there to actually get the prints, and they also are going to send me an email so I can get a QR code in case the airport is asking for that. And worst case scenario, I will show that when I get to the airport. If they ask me that, I will let you know. And by the way, we paid 600 dirhams for the test, which was an equivalent of 55 euros or $65. So that's how much it costs. So next step, now I am going to go to a place here in the city center of Rabat where I am going to go ship some of my stuff ahead of time. So it's much more affordable. So my stuff will arrive a couple of days after I arrived in Belgium. So I'm really excited because it's a lot cheaper, and that's also avoiding me to carry my stuff with me. And now I'll show you how we are actually doing this. So let's go. All right, so now we are in this location called Dior Jama here in Rabat, and I have this bag right here that I'm going to ship to Europe. All right, so we're gonna go in there. I'm gonna show you how this is done. So come on in, let's go. All right, so the next thing that I did is I went to a print shop where I printed my record locator form, because the website stated that I had to have it printed, and I also printed my boarding pass. So make sure you do that before you get to the airport. And I also have the PDF and the email copy just in case, but I print this. Then my next move is to go to the pharmacy to make sure I get the two type of mask, the surgical one and the FFP2, I think. And that's about it for now. And I will tell you what I'm doing next. Okay, so the moment of truth is here. I'm getting my results. Negative! I can fly out tomorrow. Now, we're gonna go inside the pharmacy to get the surgical masks, and then we are good to go. Let's go. Okay, we just got off the pharmacy. I needed a specific mask just to be safe. So I got an FFP2, I think it's called. So, yes, I am all good to go. Everything is printed, everything is packed, and let's go on the road to Europe from Africa. Bye! Just landed here in Belgium. We were a little over 3 hours flight. Everything went smooth. Now I'm entering Belgium airport in Charleroi. Okay, I just passed custom. All they asked me was my passport and my record locator form, and that's it. And then I went through. So I'm picking up my luggage and my friend is coming and picking me up. All right, everybody, I made it safely here in Belgium. So here's what happened. After I filled out the locator form with all my information on it, I received a couple of text messages regarding the tests, and I'm gonna tell you exactly what it said. Return from a red zone, test and quarantine of 10 days are mandatory. If you receive one test code, test on day 7. If you receive two test codes, test immediately and on day 7. If test on day 7 is negative, you may end your quarantine. Contact GP in case of symptoms. A test code will follow by text message. If obligations are not respected, a fine may follow. And then after that, I received a call this morning from the same department to just make sure I was going to go get tested. So I spoke to that person and I made an appointment to go get tested 2 days from now. So this weekend, I'm going to go get tested for my second test because I've already done one before traveling. I have to do one this weekend and I have to do another one 7 days after that to just prove that I am completely fine. And that's it. So I hope you enjoy this video. If you have any questions about traveling to Belgium coming from Morocco, let me know. Leave your comments down below and I'd be happy to help you. Thank you so much for watching this video. Don't forget to subscribe for more videos like this. And I wish you a good day. Kisses from Brussels. Bye-bye. Thank you so much for watching. Please do not forget to subscribe. We put a lot of hard work to make those videos for you. I have a free training for you, how to start your online business so you too can work from anywhere, and I will put the link down below. Lastly, follow me on Instagram @SalouaIbarin, and I'll see you next time.